After action reports were really the accounts of the battles that the commanding officers would send back either to their superior officer or they would send them back to Congress. Nathanael Greene would send his back to George Washington and then also to the President of Congress. Then Congress, in turn, the expectation was, would turn those over to the local publisher of the newspaper. They would be published there, and then they would become general knowledge as to give people a sense of, okay, here's the Battle of Guilford Courthouse, so that when wild rumors would come up that the American army was destroyed at the Battle of Guilford Courthouse, for instance, you had this after-action report that would be used to could counter that. So it was a way of reporting on the battle itself, and it was to say, okay, what was the outcome? What were the casualties? What happened? Could we have won? You know, why didn't we, or did, why did we win? So it's a rather complete version of the battle itself. Now, in addition, sometimes the newspapers would get letters where an officer or two would amplify or talk about, well, the Maryland Continental Line did this at the Battle of Guilford Courthouse, and here are some of the officers that lost their lives. They didn't usually list names for the enlisted, but they would tell the casualties by name of the officer corps. So those were the official or semi-official reports. They would send them back to Congress with an eye to the idea that they would be published. When Greene would send his things back from North or South Carolina, he would send them to Philadelphia to the President of Congress, and then it was expected that the President of Congress would then turn it over to the editor of the Pennsylvania Gazette or the editor of the, well, primarily the Gazette, but also the Pennsylvania Packet, and then they would be printed there, and then they would be used by, read by other editors up and down the coast, and reprinted as, an, you know, here's an account of what's happening in the latest in the War of the South.